Well, I think life is precious because you can't watch it again. I mean, you can believe in an afterlife if that makes you feel better. Doesn't mean it's true. But once you realise you're not going to be around forever, I think that's what makes life so magical.
Afterlife is the black comedy drama and Netflix original written by Ricky Gervais. Gervais both writes and directs, as well as stars in the lead role of Tony Johnson. Tony's life is turned upside down when his wife dies from breast cancer. He contemplates suicide, but instead decides to spend his life punishing the world for his wife's death by saying and doing whatever he feels, regardless of other people's feelings. Season 1 of Afterlife premiered on the 8th of March 2019. The second series was released in April 2020, and the third and final season premiered on the 14th of January 2022.
It's okay to admit that you're a nice bloke, you know, Tony. It's not a weakness.
Right.
I think, in your own way, you've always cared. You've always wanted people to feel better and happier. You just really enjoyed poking them until they start thinking. If it didn't kill them, you made them stronger.
I'm like an inoculation.
More like the actual annoying virus.
Here are 14 behind-the-scenes facts about Ricky Gervais's Afterlife that you haven't heard before, including which cast member took home all of their character's wardrobe, how much of Tony's personality is based on Ricky Gervais himself, and which four Afterlife actors also starred in Game of Thrones. Filming for the first season began in July 2018 in London. The series has been filmed across the south of the UK, in locations including Hampstead, Beaconsfield and Hemel Hempstead. The beach scenes were filmed at the popular tourist area Camber Sands in East Sussex.
Postcard.
Sorry about your dad, Pat. Mm. Chill.
Oh, mate.
No, it's not. It's not my dad dying. It's kindness I have a problem with. Towards me, I mean. I don't think I deserve it. And sorry about all the times I was an arsehole to you. I was just lashing out.
Arsehole? I thought it was banter.
Afterlife won the award for Best Comedy at the National Television Awards in 2021. Afterlife is the first TV series written and directed by Ricky Gervais to ever have a third season. Ricky Gervais is well known for creating comedy shows with only two seasons, including the UK version of The Office, Extras, and Derek.
Lost for words.
Tony's wife, Lisa, has the middle name Jane, which incidentally is the name of Ricky Gervais's long-term partner, Jane Fallon, a producer and author. The pair met in 1982 and decided to never get married. Ricky Gervais stated in an interview with The Times that there is no point in them having an actual ceremony before the eyes of God because there is no God.
I want you to enjoy life. I don't want you to worry about money or don't worry about me. Just worry about you, yeah? Be happy. Be kind. Be Tony.
After the filming for Afterlife had ended, Ricky Gervais kept items from his character's wardrobe.
Where have you been?
Australia.
Hmm. What is that?
You know, if you come out here and turn left, it's about 10,000 miles.
All right.
Actors David Bradley, Tony Way, Tim Plester and Paul Kaye have all worked together previously on Game of Thrones in 2011. David Bradley plays Ray Johnson, Tony's father in Afterlife, also played Walder Frey in Game of Thrones. Tony Way plays Lenny in Afterlife and he plays Sir Dontos Hollard in Game of Thrones. Tim Plester is Julian in Afterlife and he plays Black Walder Rivers in Game of Thrones, and Paul Kaye is Tony's psychiatrist in Afterlife and he plays Thoros of Maia in Game of Thrones.
You saw what I was like. I was an arsehole to everyone in the world. I hated everyone. Do you know why? Because they didn't die of cancer like Lisa. Including me. I hated me because I didn't die and I'd swap places with her tomorrow.
Sorry.
Lisa's got cancer.
No, not anymore.
Oh, good. Because I love that girl. Apple of my eye. Couldn't stand anything to happen to her.
Just a quick interruption to say thank you so much for clicking on a January Media video. If you haven't heard of us before, then take a few seconds to open a new tab, type in januarymedia.co.uk. We've got a whole host of other videos, articles and podcasts all about TV and film. So if you want to find out more facts, have a go at some of our quizzes and browse our entertainment themed shop, then make sure you visit januarymedia.co.uk after you watch this video. Tony Johnson is very matter-of-fact about death and his beliefs. This is very similar to Ricky Gervais himself, who regularly writes stand-up comedy about religion and death. Gervais himself is an atheist and a humanist.
Why do you believe that someone created it all?
Because it's so good. It can't just be chance, can it? What, the Big Bang? Everything came from nothing? That's impossible.
You're right. God did it.
Right.
So, where did God come from?
Always been around.
There you go. Easy, innit?
Actors Penelope Wilton and Peter Egan both play characters in Afterlife who have had the same first names as characters that they once played in the show Ever Decreasing Circles in 1984. Wilton plays Anne, a widow Tony meets at a local graveyard. She also played Anne Bryce in Ever Decreasing Circles alongside Richard Briers. Peter Egan plays Paul, a semi-retired owner of the Tambury Gazette, in Afterlife. He plays Paul Ryman, Penelope Wilton's character's next-door neighbour in Ever Decreasing Circles.
Oh, and there are angels, by the way. They don't have wings and live in clouds. They wear nurses' uniforms and work hard to pay the rent on their houses. Some work for charities because they can't look the other way. Some have four legs and bark. But whatever they look like, they all save lives.
Tony's beloved German Shepherd Brandy is played by Antti. As Ricky Gervais is a staunch animal rights activist, he regularly updated fans while writing the new seasons of Afterlife on Twitter, saying that the dog wouldn't die in any of them.
What do they eat?
Anything. Slippers, sticks, toys, vomit. And dog food. It's easy.
Actor Ashley Jensen has starred alongside Ricky Gervais before. In Afterlife, Jensen plays Nurse Emma, and in The Office, she plays an interviewer for two episodes. In Extras, Ashley Jensen plays Maggie Jacobs, who is main character Andy's love interest.
I've decided to go on a little trip to scatter my dad's ashes.
My ashes?
No. You're not my dad, remember?
Oh, am I adopted?
Fuck me, it's like I've got a replacement.
Ashley Jensen, who plays Nurse Emma in Afterlife, was married to British actor Terence Beasley from 2007 until 2017. Terence sadly passed away by suicide at the age of 60. The pair met on a stage production of Shakespeare's King Lear. This is incredibly poignant when you consider that Jensen stars in Afterlife, a show that discusses both untimely deaths and suicide.
Do you believe in heaven?
Definitely.
Netflix announced on the 9th of May 2018 that they had given the go-ahead on a new Ricky Gervais series consisting of 6 episodes. It was reported that Ricky Gervais would write and direct alongside producer Charlie Hanson. Charlie Hanson was suspended from his role as producer on Afterlife during the filming of the show's 3rd season. This was due to the fact that 11 women came forward saying that he had committed sexual misconduct and assault against them between 2008 and 2015. Despite there being 11 instances described, Charlie Hanson told The Times the allegations were demonstrably false. In an interview with The Times, Ricky Gervais commented that he was both shocked and appalled by the allegations.
How have I got a weaker heart than you?
It's classic. You're all pent up.
I'm all pent up. You're like a ball of fury all the time.
Calm down. Breathe. You've got all the same stress and anger as me, but I shout at people and call them cunts and smash things up. You keep it all in. It's got to go somewhere.
Comedian Kerry Godliman has previously worked alongside Ricky Gervais in his Channel 4 show Derek. She played the role of Hannah, the care home's manager. In Afterlife, she plays Tony's beloved wife, Lisa.
Obviously, I was still lactating, so I thought waste not, want not. So I expressed and started making rice puddings.
Out of your breast milk.
Good idea.
Joe Wilkinson, who plays Afterlife's postman Pat, has also worked alongside Godliman and Gervais in Derek as the character Cliff.
Got a good lead for you. Local baby looks exactly like Adolf Hitler.
Boom, boom. Yeah.
Yeah.
Boom.
So, is that a birthmark?
Oh, no, it's eyeliner. We did it with marker pen at first, but it took ages to get off.
Yeah, I mean, this way we can do it when we want, then wipe it off if we need to.
Mandeep Dhillon, who plays Sandy, the newly hired features journalist in Afterlife, has previously worked with Gervais in his film David Brent Life on the Road, which came out in 2016. She starred as Karen Parashar, the receptionist at the bathroom supply firm Lavachem.
I need your names to put them in the paper so everyone knows how brilliant you are.
I'm Millie.
Millie.
I'm Lisa.
Lisa. My wife's name.
Where is she?
She's at home.
Making your tea?
Yeah.
Why are you crying?
Because I'm happy.
Why are you crying if you're happy?
Because I'm mental.
Ride Along 2 5 times.
Well, you haven't wasted your life then.
Definitely not.